We want to find the volume of the solid with each face at x is a triangle with a base of 4 inches, as we see here, and a height of y equals x squared, graphed here in blue, over the closed interval from 0 to 2 along the x-axis. So because if we take a slice of this solid and the faces are perpendicular to the x-axis, we can determine the volume using this definite integral here, where a of x would be the area of any face. So the volume is equal to the definite integral of a of x integrated with respect to x from a to b. To help us set up our integral though, let's first find the approximate volume of a single slice, let's say this yellow slice here. To determine the volume of this slice, we'll determine the area of the face, then multiply it by the thickness, which would be delta x. Notice how the face is a triangle, where the area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 base times height. So to find the volume, we'll first find the area of the face, which would be 1/2 times the base, which has a length of 4 units, or in this case 4 inches. So we have 1/2 times 4 times the height, which would be this length here. Notice how this is determined by the function value y equals x squared. So the height would be x squared. This is the area of the face, or a of x, but our goal here is to find the volume of the slice, so we'll multiply the area by the thickness, which is delta x. So this would be the volume of a single slice, and therefore the volume of the solid would be approximately equal to the sum of the volume of the number of slices we determined to find, which would be the sum of a of x sub I times delta x sub I. And the idea is, if we let the number of slices approach infinity, it would equal this definite integral here. So we can say the actual volume of the solid is equal to the integral of a of x, which again is the area of any face, which would be 1/2 times 4 times x squared, or just 2x squared, integrated with respect to x from 0 to 2. So the antiderivative would be 2 times x to the third divided by 3, or 2/3 x to the third. We'd evaluate this at the upper and lower limits of integration. So we'd have 2/3 times 2 cubed minus 2/3 times 0 cubed. So this would give us, what, 2/3 times 8, or 8 over 1, minus 2/3 times 0. So this would be 16/3, which is the volume of our solid on the closed interval from 0 to 2. But the units are inches, so let's write this as 16/3 cubic inches. I hope you found this helpful.